Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to a brand new video. I hope you are all having a lovely weekend so far. I thought today, it has been a while since I've done a dedicated kind of white company dupes video. So those of you that love them, hopefully you're going to enjoy today's video. I am going to tie it in with a bit of an Amazon haul first because that's kind of initially what spurred me on to do some kind of white company dupes video, because I put in an order on Amazon and there was one thing in particular which I will end on, which is a white company dupe. So I thought that would lead me nicely into some other white company dupes that I have found along the way. We've got a couple of Neptune dupes like Zara Home, bits like that. So if you haven't already, grab a cuppa. I'm on a peppermint tea today. Get comfy, get cozy, and I will jump straight into today's video. If you're wondering where this dress is from as well, by the way, I'll show you because it's so, I love it. It's from the new Paula range at Primark. Let me just slide that to one side. They only had sizes 16 and 18 left, so I did go for 16, but because of the belt, it doesn't really matter what size you get. If you can size up, it doesn't have pockets, which is a bit of a shame, but regardless, it's a lovely simple light linen summer's dress that I feel I will wear quite a lot throughout the warmer months. I have a Primark haul coming in my next video. I've got loads of bits. Honestly, her range is stunning. She's got some gorgeous new finds, so stay tuned for my next video if you want to see all of the bits that I picked up from Primark. And speaking of Primark, I do actually have a white company fashion dupe from Primark, which I've got right next to me to one side, which I will show you in this video. So let's have a sip. It's still quite hot. Everything that I will mention in this video, if I can, if it's online, I will leave linked in the description box below. Oh, it's heavy, which means there are some books in here. I just can't help myself with nice looking coffee table books or cooking books, everything like that from Amazon. I find they're so much cheaper. I get inspiration from places like Daylesford, which we went in our Cotswolds vlog, if you saw, and they had some beautiful books out and I actually vlogged it. And then I went back and looked on that vlogging clip and thought, which of these books do I like the look of? And let me see if they're cheaper on Amazon. Some of them were. So I did pick up a few, but this one, this is actually an older book that they created. It's called A Love for Food. And it's recipes and notes for cooking and eating well. So they've got loads of different recipes, some imagery, and I'm thinking of switching out in our pantry area to the works surface to have some more of my nice cooking books out on display, because if I know they're there, I'm more likely to reach for them, and obviously they look nice as well. So that is the plan with that one. Next up, I picked up this book, Off-Baked Harvest. More than 120 all-new, soul-satisfying recipes with a focus on feeling good from the New York Times best-selling author of Half-Baked Harvest Super Simple. This is like everyday recipes for balanced, flexible, feel-good meals. And I find, look at even just that dish alone, that pasta. I'm such a sucker for pasta. I find Tom and I have just been a little more conscious of the choices we make when it comes to cooking. Obviously, we still have our naughty treats. I still have a little McDonald's trip every once in a while, or a Five Guys. That's very normal for me. But when we are cooking from home and, you know, doing like our HelloFresh recipes, which inspires us to cook fresh food, or if we don't have a HelloFresh, or if we're wanting a lunch option or something, I'm finding us reaching more for just fresh ingredients rather than processed. Like, I can't even tell you the last time I bought a processed meal from the shop, you know, like a ready meal, pop in the microwave. I just don't do that anymore. What other books have I got? Oh, we've got this one, which is called The Modern Preserver's Kitchen, and this is by Kylie Newton, Cooking with Jam, Chutney, Pickles and Ferments. So we've got the outdoor kitchen, especially these sort of like jarred goods, preserved goods. I'm thinking Pantry of Dreams. Got chutneys in here. Ooh, chocolate mousse, macro pate, salads. So yeah, all sorts in here. I don't know if this is actually owned. Seed magazines, if they are in any way linked to Daylesford, but they had them for sale. And yeah, so I had a quick look on Amazon. I got these. This one is autumn winter 2020. And again, it's just all different recipes and reading material, but I just like the look of them. So like even set out on display, they're only a magazine, so they're more affordable than a coffee table book. And then this one actually is volume 2, spring summer 2020, celebrating food, craft, travel, sustainable living. So yeah, oh, just the aesthetics. Is that Daylesford? That is Daylesford. Okay, so maybe they are somehow correlated to Daylesford. Interesting. I'm excited to have a little flick through those actually. I'll do that once I've finished filming this video with my tea. Wow, I'm such a brand loyal fan with Daylesford, because this is a peppermint tea from Daylesford as well. And this mug is the Neptune Bosley mug, of which we have a little Bosley dupe in this video. Coming shortly. Okay, another two books we've got, and this one is called The Fast Five, Shortcuts to Deliciousness by Donna Hay. Again, love the aesthetic of this book, but it is more than just that, and it is very much a inspo book to healthy food. I think that was also something that we, again, I keep going on about blooming Daylesford, but something we appreciated when we got there is the food that they cooked on site was very conscious, even to the point where in the evening we said, oh, just 2 Diet Cokes, please. And they said, well, we don't do Diet Cokes. We do Daylesford's own ginger beer. And we thought, yeah, we'll have that. And it was delicious. But they're really stripped back with the food and drink that they provide. So anyway, that is another book that I got. Lastly, the last book that I got from Amazon is this, Sustainable Garden. In Sustainable Garden, landscape architect Marion Boswell walks us through the process of creating and maintaining sustainable outdoor spaces, offering insight, advice, step-by-step projects designed to help you lead a more low-impact lifestyle, which very much is on theme right now for us in our lives with us doing the garden at the moment. If you've been following along in the vlogs, our garden is coming along nicely and we'll definitely be set and ready to enjoy the summer sun. We started it early enough so that we can enjoy a summer in the garden, which I'm so looking forward to. I'm just looking outside now. It's a little hectic out there, but we're making progress. If you want to see where we're at currently, then I've just updated you guys on my Instagram homeware account, and I've just saved them to a highlighted tab. So if you wanted to see what the garden is looking like, be sure to head over there. My Pinterest board is very busy right now with lots of inspirational images, what kind of flowers I want, the look I want. I need to be buying when I go to my garden center trips coming in the summer. Oh, can't wait. Anyway, again, this is just ridiculous. Another Bamford, Daylesford inspired purchase is when we stayed in the little cottages at Daylesford. They had lots of enamel bakeware, which I really liked, and a lot of our baking trays were in need of replacing, let's just say. And so I picked up this 3-pack of enamel kind of like baking dishes. We have a couple that small size already, but it'd be quite handy to have some of these larger ones. Some nice new enamel bakeware there. And then another item before I move on to the kind of dupes part of this video. A few of you have asked since I first mentioned the gel nail strips that I love from the brand Moyu. There are several different brands that do them, but I've seen that they've brought out some new kind of neutral designs. So I did stock up on some. Look how pretty these ones are. If I just come a bit closer. They've got little stars on. How pretty are they? And that's exactly why I like these ones so much, is because when you do your own at-home gel nails, at least for me anyway, it's very hard to do any kind of a nail art. Anything other than just a plain, simple color is about all I can do. So these just allow you to have a bit more fun whilst doing your nails from the comfort of your own home. So you do have to have an LED lamp. Again, I'll leave these along with the LED lamp that I use. Oh, there's a robin on the bird feeder and there's no food out there. I need to go fill it out. Now the last of the Amazon purchases and the first of my kind of dupes is this bedspread. And I saw this and, gosh, again, wow, I really am a broken record here. Loved this bedspread that they had on at Daylesford. I had a look at the tab and it was from the White Company. And it's the Vintage Etienne bedspread, I think it's called. Now we have a Super King bed at £140. This one for a Super King, and you get two pillowcases in here. It's just £40 from Amazon. 80% cotton as well, so really nice kind of pattern. On a recent vlog, I went into the White Company and showed a toweling set, like a shorts and long sleeve set, which I loved. It was £65 for the top, £45 for the shorts. And then, like I said, I've got a Primark fashion find here, because when I went into Primark and saw that Paula had done this new edit and brought out this set, I thought, that's just like the White Company one. So I decided to pick it up and share it with you guys. I got the top in a large at £11, the shorts in a medium at £8. I'm just pottering around the house, popping in the garden, doing your gardening, and just having this lovely toweling set on holiday as well. It would be lovely. More of these finds to come, like I said, in that Primark haul next. But for now, I had to mention that as a bit of a White Company dupe. They also have, again from that Paula range, a suit. Like a waistcoat suit set. So trousers, waistcoat, blazer, which looked very similar to the one that the White Company have just brought out as well. And those prices are, the White Company sort of from £100 to £160, with the Primark versions being from about £14 to £25, £26. So significantly different. Next, I'm gonna show you this jug as a dupe for the Portobello jug that they have on the White Company for £35. Essentially just a standard white jug. But I saw this one in HomeSense and I actually think I preferred it because of the shape and also the texture. I really, really liked it. So I picked it up. I think it was $4.99 from memory, either $4 or $5.99. I love these little jugs for obviously as and when you're hosting, for on the table, but also as a little vase. Regular viewers may have seen this before on my channel, but I have this cake stand also from HomeSense or TK Maxx. Their kickstands are usually around the $12.99 mark, and this kind of bobble edged detail reminded me of the Neptune Bosey range, like I was saying earlier, with their Bosey range, which I love. If you do want the kind of bobble edged design, they do have a similar alternative in HomeSense TK Maxx with the crockery as well, not just a cake stand. But Neptune cake stands are about £36 in comparison. This was also an Amazon purchase, but a while ago now, and it's this standard like double oven glove with this really nice kind of texture to it. And it reminded me of the rustic texture that they do on the White Company double oven glove. They've got like a new one, which is just plain and simple like this. The White Company charged £38, whereas the Amazon one is just the bargain price of £5. And even just as one to throw it over the oven door, just to have out, to add that nice texture. This is more of a Zara home dupe now, because I saw these colanders in Sainsbury's. You actually get a pack of two for £7, whereas the Zara home ones, individually, I think they're about £10 and £20 for these kind of cream lacquered colanders. But yeah, the fact that you get the set as well, I thought was great value for money. So make sure to check out Habitat. I feel like they are the best in terms of supermarket homeware. I also showed these placemats not too long ago from H&M Home, which I picked up six or eight, I can't remember. But they are lovely. I love the color of this. I couldn't find a dupe for this color, but the White Company have some placemats very similar. They charge £20 for two. These ones were £12.99 for two. But Neptune as well. Neptune have some, again, very similar. They have a white and I think a blue. The Emily placemats, they're called, and they come in a set of six, but for £70. Of all of the different colors, the White Company, Neptune, this actually is my favorite color, this kind of washed sage green. I wanted to show this hurricane vase, which I picked up again from HomeSense at, it was about £7 actually, £7.99. So quite big as well for that. And yeah, it reminded me of the hurricane vases that they do either on the White Company and also Neptune. I know the Neptune one is called the Newington vase. Also, IKEA have a very similar range, which has a similar shape from about £2.50. Again, really affordable. If you happen to be popping to IKEA, bear that in mind when you walk through the kind of the market section where everyone starts filling up the baskets. And yeah, I do actually have a Neptune candle in this one. This is just like a, what do they call this color? Fig maybe, I think. Another thing that IKEA do is the doormats, very similar to the Woodbury doormats from the White Company. They're around £50, whereas the IKEA ones start from about £2.50 to £4. I think there's one that looks quite good for £4. This one I picked up, this is the Lowhells one it's called, and it was, well, it's £17 full price, but I picked it up from the bargain corner. I can't remember how much I paid for it, but it was probably about a fiver. So be sure to check out that bargain corner for some good finds at IKEA. I'll pop an image on screen of a table that I actually thrifted. It was from a vintage store and I paid £30 for it. It's like a folding table. So it's got this mechanism underneath that folds and it's very similar, a bit smaller in comparison, but also a lot cheaper than the folding table that the White Company do for £365. Oh, and then also on IKEA, I didn't buy one, but I did see that they've got these sheepskin seat pads for £9. They're in this sale at the moment. And I know the White Company have the sheepskin round seat pads as well. And then also another thing on that table that I've got in the other room is the White Company Pimlico lamp, which is actually quite a big lamp. And I don't know if it's going to stay there. I feel like it looks a bit lost and out of place on that table, but I just wanted to do a little video just to show you which one I'm talking about. So that lamp is £175, but I saw in Dunelm. Yeah, the Dunelm one is only £55. And they also actually have the round fluted glass lamps, which again are very similar to the ones that the White Company do. The Overton lamp, I think they're called it, £125. And then one other Amazon purchase that I was going to make, but didn't, and I still might, I don't know yet, but I saw it, I thought that's just like the one that the White Company have done, because they've started doing portable lamps as well. It's like a black portable lamp that you can just pop on your table, recharge it, and just be the flexibility of being able to move it is really good. And for us, with this dining table not having any lights overhead other than just the spotlights when we're hosting in an evening and it's dark, the spotlights are a bit too much, so we like to just have some portable lamps on the table, which I have from Amazon, but they're more of a brushed brass. But the White Company ones that they do, they're £125. And I think from Amazon, they start from around the £15 mark. So that is everything that I wanted to share with you. It's my little Amazon haul slash dupes video. Let me know which was your favorite find. And of course, if you have any other White Company dupes, Neptune dupes, fire them over to my inbox. I love seeing what you guys find out in the shops as well. And yeah, stay tuned for my Primark haul coming next with some amazing finds. Probably one of my favorite Primark hauls I have ever done. So make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified when that video is uploaded. Thank you so much for watching. Have a lovely rest of your day. I hope you have a good one and I hope to see you all very, very soon in my next video. Bye guys.